Even that, you want to talk about the economy. You want a sign of how the economy is doing. Again, you look at crowdfunding. Look at crowdfunding. After George Zimmerman killed Trayvon Martin, he received over $100,000 in online donations. $100,000. And the police officer in Ferguson who killed Mike Brown, in 4 days, he received over $400,000 just in online donations. $400,000 in 4 days. I have never made that kind of money, and I have been on television. Like, you see that, and it's just like, what the fuck is the going rate on killing a kid? Because I could do that. I've met many children I would love to kill. I could make money doing it. And those are sad stories, but those are also signs of a really strong economy. Seriously, because those are people who are basically saying, yeah, I know he did it, but I want to see where this goes. Those are sad stories. Like, all those stories, the last few years are just so many sad stories. In New York, it was Eric Garner. Here, there was Tony Robinson and Tamir Rice in Cleveland and Rainisha McBride, Sandra Bland, Freddie Gray in Baltimore, Walter Scott. So many sad stories. And it just breaks my heart. As a black person, it breaks my heart. And it just feels terrible because it feels like, again, like the song is the same. The instruments are different. But at the same time, I get encouraged because I see people using like social media to get the word out and to get people motivated and activated. And that's been beautiful to see that, to get to hear the stories get told. And in New York, where I live, Eric Garner was this man. He was choked out by the NYPD and he died. And so there was a big march in New York City to protest what happened. And I went, and it was beautiful. There were thousands of people, and we're all marching up Manhattan. We went from lower Manhattan and just marched all the way up through the city, and it was beautiful. People from all walks of life, all ages. It was a beautiful day. Everybody's marching. It was peaceful. It was people singing. It was beautiful. And I remember I was walking. I'd been walking for a while, and I looked at this dude next to me. I didn't know him, and I just looked at him. I was like, hey, man, where are we headed? He was like, what you mean, we marching? I was like, right, no, I get that. We've been walking for a while, and I made a bad shoe choice. He was like, man, we just marching, just march. Right, no, I get that. I'm just wondering, are we hitting a specific destination? Like, are we dropping something off? Because I don't know if you heard, but I love the choo-choo, and there's a train right there. I could meet you. He was like, man, we just marching. We marching to let these cops know they can't get away with stuff like this anymore. I was like, right, no, I totally understand that. I totally get that. I get it. It's just, I don't know if you know this, but do you see all the police who are blocking off traffic for us right now? They get paid overtime for this. So at the moment, while we are having a march for justice, we're also having a parade for police appreciation. That's why they're so cool with it. Because that's the thing, cops get paid overtime for stuff like that. During the early days of Occupy Wall Street, when the protesters camped out in Zuccotti Park outside in New York City, the NYPD, they had to be paid $2 million just in overtime. $2 million, that's a lot of money, and that's taxpayer money. You could do so much with $2 million. $2 million, we could have just donated $2 million directly to Occupy Wall Street, and they could have just started a hedge fund. Seriously, that's the amount of money you need to start a hedge fund. You need $2 million. They could have just started a hedge fund, and then instead of camping out outside, they could have camped out directly on the Wall Street trading room floor and fuck shit up from in there. Where people are just like, buy, buy, sell, sell, spirit fingers! Oh, you gonna ring that bell? We're gonna have a drum circle! You could do so much with $2 million. You want to talk police reform? That buys body cameras. That creates training programs. $2 million. Hell, for $2 million, you can get NBA shooting guard Ray Allen. It's what's known as the mid-level exception. And I'm not even talking for the Knicks. I'm talking for the city of New York. We could have bought Ray Allen for a year. Because here's the thing, you look at like Occupy Wall Street, you look at these leaderless movements, you look at how social media is activating people, and all that stuff is great, but we still need leaders. We need people to step up. And it's so hard to be a leader. It's hard to be a leader right now. because people try to take shots at you. They go and they like they try to tear you down on the internet. Like, it's so hard. It's a lot of pressure to be a leader. But you know who loves pressure? Three-point specialist Ray Allen. Fucking lives for it. You don't want to deal with it? Kick it out to Ray. And if I could stay with basketball analogies for a moment, that Eric Garner march that I went to, just to police that march, the NYPD were paid $18 million just in overtime. $18 million just in overtime to police that one march, which that is exactly what New York Knicks small forward Carmelo Anthony makes in a year. So to be clear, the city of New York has a problem overpaying dudes who shoot too damn much. And I'm not trying to make a statement. That's just the most socially conscious way I could say the Knicks need to trade Carmelo Anthony.